Welcome to the Strategy Mom Podcast. Tune in for everything you need to know to stay in the know regarding the automotive industry. Here's your host, Jason Harris.
I think a lot of businesses have to realize that when they think of a community, you're not setting out to build millions and millions and millions of people following, because that's really not even necessary, right? If a restaurant had, and same thing even with the dealership, if they had 3,000 loyal customers that would almost literally provide their more than 50% of their entire business for the rest of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Like, well, and it's like, not the intent. We don't have followers to build it. What is a follower, right? Like, that's a good point. There was something I was going to bring up earlier when you were talking about the restaurant. I have a restaurant here. You'd love this. I have this strategy. I call it social worthiness. So it's like, what do you do as a business that's social worthy? And I find like restaurants, it's the easiest thing in the world, right? Because mm-hmm. they're food, and there's this thing called food porn. And people get high on just going through their feeds and just looking at amazing dishes and food. And it's a thing. And so there's a local diner here. It was just a lunch and breakfast place. Nothing special, right? Decided to go make 14 different milkshakes. And each one is easily over the top of the other one. I mean, you got donuts coming out of them. You got sparklers coming out of them. You got literally like chunk of cake hanging out of another one. You have churros sticking out like a bouquet of flowers out of it with chocolate-covered strawberries and all this stuff. And I'm going to tell you right now, the milkshake, it's just a milkshake. It's good. I mean, it's good. But there's a social worthy element to it. So if you go and look them up right now, you can actually look them up as a business. What you're going to find is not a whole lot of information about the business. What you're going to find is 14,000 pictures of people taking selfies of themselves with these milkshakes.
Yes. So
I call it social worthiness. Why would someone want to come to your business and snap that photo or be a part of that community? Or, you know, it's like it's wearing the badge. Like I was a Boy Scout. I don't know if you did. Did you do anything like Girl Scouts or anything like that when you were a kid? Okay, well, you know, like you get these badges for everything you do. Everything you achieve, you get a badge for, right? So it's like I talked to a business and I'm like, okay, well, why would someone get their ABC Motors badge? Like, why would they wear that, right? What they want to wear with pride, you know? So going down kind of that strategy, what are your thoughts? Do you have some ideas or even some examples of some of your own clients that have created kind of this social worthy style strategy?
We try to push everyone, you know, to do that. I will say this, and this is the analogy I use going into it. And another reason why I chose the Phoenix Factor. If you want to start a fire, right, you need people to see you. You need to be visible. So how do we start the fire? You got to have kindling. You got to have the spark. You got to have the base of what the business is going to be. And then, you know, as they say, where there's smoke, there's fire. So eventually you get to this point where people
see. I like
see,
that analogy. That's so true.
You know, I mean, they see it everywhere. So how do you make that happen? You've got to get people, like you said, with that. I love that term. I'm going to steal that, social worthiness. But it's like, how do we get there? And then at the same time, how exhausting would it be? Because we know what happens if you start a fire and you're throwing logs, right? You're throwing your logs of consistency in your social media.
You got to keep it burning.
Right. You got to keep it going. And so our term is, how do we create an inferno of success? Because when you have an inferno, guess what happens? You can take a little break. You can go to Tahiti for 3 days. You can do those things, because when you have an inferno, even if it were to lessen, which hopefully you have things in place, operation systems and strategies where that doesn't happen. But even if it did, you still have a freaking roaring fire, right? If you're not consistent, you don't have those things in place, your fire is going to go out and you're starting over. And we see people doing this also. They're doing the wrong thing consistently because they're quitting and starting over.
And starting over. It's the worst thing you can possibly do.
Yeah. So, you know, that's kind of the analogy I use with that for you to have that social worthiness, meaning why would people share your content or tag you or check in? And you have to tell them these things. They don't know. They don't know they're hurting their business. You know, I mean, it makes me cringe when I see people that post and I'm like, why didn't you tag the business? Why didn't you, you know, or so it's like, and the great thing now is I'm on the hashtag game, because hashtags are now SEO for every platform. TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, all of them, you can now search hashtags. So this is how I network and this is how I go in and find my people, right? Because I know it's not necessarily the person that used the hashtag, it's the person following that person that used that hashtag.
Thanks for tuning in to the Strategy Mob Podcast with your host, Jason Harris. Don't want to miss new content? Be sure to sign up to be a mobster at strategymob.com to stay in the know. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Happy podcasting.